Dear listeners, tonight I invite you to journey with me into the heart of ancient Babylon, a land where legends were born and dark forces once roamed. In this tale, we will witness the courage and determination of three brave souls as they face a terrifying demon named Ashtar. As they navigate through treacherous terrains and confront the shadows that threaten their beloved city, we will uncover a story of unity, strength, and hope. So, close your eyes and let the magic of this ancient tale envelop you. Demon Hunters of Babylon. Battle against darkness in ancient Babylon. In the middle of ancient Babylon, amid elegant temples and bustling streets, a tiny but momentous event set the stage for mayhem. The city, known for its splendor and rich culture, prospered under the careful eye of its gods. Its temples, full with followers, reverberated with prayers and offerings, while the marketplaces hummed with the vibrant energy of traders and locals. The sun was shining brightly in Babylon, highlighting the city's stunning ziggurats and lush gardens, and projecting an image of peace and prosperity. In a forgotten corner of this majestic city, a crumbling temple stood in silent decay, its once sacred halls now cloaked in dust and shadows. The temple, once a hub of spiritual activity, had fallen into neglect as newer, grander structures rose in prominence. Its stone walls, etched with ancient symbols and faded murals, whispered tales of a bygone era. It was here, driven by insatiable curiosity, that a young scribe ventured into the depths of the temple. This scribe, whose name history has forgotten, was an ardent seeker of knowledge, always in pursuit of the mysteries of the past. The scribe's footsteps echoed softly through the deserted corridors, stirring the dust that had settled over centuries. Sunlight filtered through cracks in the walls, casting ethereal beams that illuminated the path ahead. The air was thick with the scent of age and decay, mingling with the faint aroma of incense that lingered like a ghostly reminder of the temple's former glory. As the scribe delved deeper into the temple, he stumbled upon a hidden chamber, concealed behind a tapestry of cobwebs and overgrown vines. The room was dimly lit, with only a few rays of light managing to penetrate the thick foliage covering the windows. In the center of the chamber lay an ancient, ornate seal, its intricate carvings depicting scenes of celestial battles and divine intervention. The seal pulsated with a faint, eerie glow, as if guarding a secret too powerful to be revealed. With a trembling hand, the scribe reached out, his fingers brushing against the cold, smooth surface of the seal. At that very moment, the seal shattered, releasing a torrent of dark energy that reverberated through the ancient stone. The chamber was engulfed in a blinding light, and a chilling wind swept through the temple, extinguishing the last remnants of its sacred aura. From the shattered seal emerged Ashtar, a demon of immense power, imprisoned for centuries by the ancient priests. His form, dark and menacing, filled the chamber with an aura of malevolence. His eyes, glowing like molten embers, pierced through the darkness, and his presence exuded an overwhelming sense of dread. The very air seemed to tremble in his wake, and the ground beneath him cracked and splintered. Freed from his confinement, Ashtar unleashed his fury upon Babylon. His wrath was swift and merciless, spreading like wildfire through the city. The skies darkened as a tempest of shadow and lightning engulfed Babylon, and the once vibrant streets echoed with cries of fear and despair. Ashtar's dark magic seeped into the hearts of the citizens, corrupting their souls and turning them into mindless thralls of his will. Neighbors turned against neighbors, friends became foes, and the city descended into chaos. Nightmarish creatures, summoned by Ashtar's malevolent power, prowled the streets, enforcing his reign of terror. These abominations, twisted and grotesque, were the embodiment of the demon's hatred and fury. They roamed the city, spreading fear and destruction wherever they went. The grand temples that had once been sanctuaries of peace and devotion now stood as dark citadels of despair. The city, once a beacon of civilization, now trembled under the weight of Ashtar's evil. The gardens withered, and the waters of the great Euphrates turned murky and foul. The air grew thick with smoke and the acrid stench of decay. The citizens of Babylon, who had known only prosperity and peace, now faced a future shrouded in darkness and terror. In the midst of this growing calamity, a sense of foreboding settled over the city. The once proud and mighty Babylon now lay at the mercy of an ancient evil, its fate hanging in the balance. The malevolent influence of Ashtar spread with terrifying swiftness, casting a pall over the once vibrant city of Babylon. The city, which had flourished under the benevolent gaze of its gods, now lay shrouded in a grim shadow. The harmonious streets, where the laughter of children once mingled with the melodies of street musicians, now echoed with cries of anguish and the terrifying roars of demonic creatures. The markets, once bustling with life and commerce, were deserted, their stalls overturned, and goods scattered in the chaos. The serene temples, sanctuaries of peace and devotion, stood in ruins, overshadowed by the growing darkness. Amidst this chaos, the citizens of Babylon found themselves gripped by a profound sense of despair. The air was thick with fear, and the once joyful faces were now etched with worry and sorrow. Families huddled together in their homes, whispering prayers for protection, while the bravest among them ventured out to seek any sign of hope. In a secluded corner of the city, Asher, a wise and devoted priest of Marduk, pored over sacred texts in a desperate search for answers. The flickering light of an oil lamp cast long shadows on the ancient manuscripts spread before him. Asher's heart ached for his people, and his mind raced to uncover a way to combat the encroaching evil. His extensive knowledge of ancient rituals and divine incantations had led him to a glimmer of hope. The very seal that had once imprisoned Ashtar could be used again. This discovery filled Ashtar with a renewed sense of purpose. Determined to save his city, he knew he could not do it alone. Meanwhile, far from the heart of the city, in a place of solitude and reflection, Lilith, an exiled witch with unparalleled magical abilities, sensed the growing peril. Her exile had not dimmed her resolve to protect Babylon. On the contrary, it had strengthened her determination to stand against the darkness. Lilith's heart was heavy with the knowledge of the suffering inflicted upon her homeland. With a deep sense of duty, she prepared to join the battle, bringing her vast knowledge of sorcery and magical artifacts to the cause. Lilith's journey back to the city was fraught with danger, but her resolve never wavered. The sight of her once beautiful city, now cloaked in darkness, steeled her determination. She moved with grace and purpose, her every step guided by an inner strength that burned brighter than the shadows around her. As she approached the temple where Asher had taken refuge, she felt a surge of hope, knowing that together they stood a chance against Ashtor. Enki, a warrior famed for his bravery and strength, had witnessed the devastation firsthand. His heart burned with a fierce resolve to protect his city and its people from the demonic threat. Enki's skills in battle were unparalleled, and his unyielding spirit made him a formidable ally. As the darkness spread, he gathered his weapons and set out to find those who, like him, were ready to stand against the tide of evil. The paths of Asher, Lilith, and Enki converged at the temple. Their meeting was one of both relief and determination. Though their backgrounds were diverse, their goal was singular: to save Babylon from the clutches of Ashtar. Asher, with his deep knowledge of rituals and incantations, laid out the plan to reseal the demon. Lilith, with her mastery of sorcery, offered her magical prowess to protect and enhance their efforts. Enki, with his strength and combat skills, pledged to defend his companions and ensure their mission succeeded. The temple, once a place of quiet devotion, now buzzed with the energy of their preparation. Sacred texts and magical artifacts were laid out with care, each item representing a piece of their collective hope. The air was thick with a sense of urgency, but also with a newfound sense of unity. The trio knew that their journey would be perilous, but they were united in their determination to face the looming darkness. As they ventured into the heart of the city, they encountered scenes of devastation that tested their resolve. The streets, once lively and filled with the sounds of daily life, were now eerily silent, save for the occasional distant roar of a demonic creature. The trio moved cautiously, their senses heightened to every potential threat. Despite the overwhelming odds, they pressed on, drawing strength from one another. Asher's wisdom and leadership provided guidance. Lilith's magical abilities offered protection, and Enki's bravery and strength gave them the confidence to confront the dangers that lay ahead. Together, they formed an unlikely but determined team, their bond growing stronger with each step they took. The rise of darkness had set the stage for a monumental struggle, one that would test their limits and challenge their very souls. Yet, in the midst of the encroaching shadows, the light of their resolve burned bright. Asher, Lilith, and Enki stood ready to face the ultimate test. Their hearts united in the fight to reclaim Babylon from the grip of evil. Their journey to the ancient temple, where the seal could be reactivated, was filled with peril. The once familiar paths of Babylon had transformed into treacherous terrains, where deadly traps awaited the unwary. The vibrant streets they had known were now desolate, the comforting sounds of daily life replaced by an eerie silence. Each step forward was met with the threat of unseen dangers, as if the very city had conspired to test their resolve. The trio moved cautiously, their senses heightened to every potential hazard. Enki, with his unmatched reflexes and warrior instincts, took the lead. His eyes scanned the surroundings, alert to the slightest movement or change. His keen awareness was their first line of defense against the hidden perils that lay in wait. Asher, with his deep well of wisdom, followed closely behind. He studied the cryptic symbols and ancient markings that adorned the temple walls, his mind deciphering their meanings and revealing hidden clues. These symbols, remnants of a long-forgotten era, were both a guide and a warning. Asher's knowledge of ancient texts was invaluable in navigating the complex labyrinth that the temple had become. Lilith, bringing up the rear, wielded her magical prowess with precision and care. Her senses attuned to the flow of arcane energies, she detected and disarmed magical traps that would have otherwise ensnared them. Her spells created a protective aura around the group, shielding them from the dark forces that permeated the air. The trio's combined skills formed a seamless unit, each member's strengths compensating for the other's vulnerabilities. As they ventured deeper into the heart of the temple, the challenges they faced became more formidable. The temple itself seemed to pulse with a malevolent life, its ancient mechanisms designed to thwart any who dared to disturb its secrets. They encountered narrow passages filled with hidden spikes, floors that crumbled beneath their feet, and walls that closed in without warning. In one particularly harrowing passage, they found themselves trapped between two converging walls. Enki's swift reflexes saved them as he spotted a barely visible lever hidden in the shadows. With a surge of strength, he pulled the lever just in time, halting the wall's advance. Asher quickly deciphered the glyphs that reset the mechanism, ensuring they would not be trapped again. Lilith's magic illuminated their path, revealing the hidden dangers before they could cause harm. The deeper they delved, the more evident it became that the temple was not only a physical challenge, but also a test of their will and unity. Their bond was tested by the relentless pressure of their mission, the constant threat of danger, and the weight of the city's fate resting on their shoulders. But with each trial they overcame, their determination grew stronger, and their trust in one another deepened. One night, as they approached the temple's gates, a massive horde of demons emerged from the shadows, their eyes glowing with malevolence. Under the pale moonlight, the air filled with the chilling sound of demonic growls and the clashing of weapons. Enki, ever the valiant warrior, stepped forward to confront the overwhelming odds. His sword flashed in the moonlight, a beacon of hope amidst the darkness. He fought with a ferocity that belied his exhaustion, his every movement precise and powerful. Beside him, Lilith cast protective spells that formed shimmering barriers, repelling the demon's attacks and giving Enki the space he needed to strike. Her voice, steady and unwavering, chanted incantations that filled the air with a palpable energy. The demon's dark magic clashed against her spells, sparks flying as the forces of light and darkness battled for supremacy. Asher, standing between his two companions, raised his arms and began to chant ancient incantations. His voice, rich with authority and faith, infused the group with renewed strength. His words seemed to resonate with the very stones of the temple, weakening the demons and bolstering his allies. Each syllable was a weapon, each phrase a shield, driving back the tide of darkness that threatened to overwhelm them. The battle raged on, each passing moment a test of their endurance and courage. The demons, though numerous and fierce, were no match for the combined might of Asher, Lilith, and Enki. Slowly but surely, the trio pushed back the horde, their unity and determination shining brighter than the moonlight that bathed the battlefield. Exhausted but undeterred, they finally defeated the last of the demonic horde. The air was thick with the remnants of magic and the scent of battle. But the path to the temple's inner sanctum lay open before them. The trio stood for a moment, catching their breath and gathering their strength. They knew that the final challenge awaited them beyond those gates, the culmination of their perilous journey and the key to Babylon's salvation. Within the sacred heart of the ancient temple, the atmosphere was charged with a sense of impending destiny. The air was thick with anticipation, and the faint glow of the ancient carvings and glyphs on the walls seemed to acknowledge the significance of the moment. These inscriptions, etched by long-forgotten hands, pulsated softly, as if the temple itself was holding its breath. Asher took his place at the center of the chamber, his presence calm yet commanding. His deep, steady breaths matched the rhythmic cadence of his heart, a heart filled with the knowledge that this moment was the culmination of all their efforts. He began to chant the ancient incantations necessary to seal Ashtar once more. His voice, resonant and powerful, filled the cavernous space, each syllable imbued with the sacred power of Marduk. Lilith, her eyes alight with determination and a fierce protective instinct, stood nearby. Her hands moved in intricate patterns, weaving spells that shimmered in the dim light. Each motion was precise, each spell a masterpiece of arcane art. Her barriers rose around Asher, glowing with a vibrant energy that clashed with the dark magic emanating from Ashtar. The demon's power battered against her shields, but she stood firm, a bastion of strength and resilience. Meanwhile, Enki faced Ashtar directly. His sword, a gleaming beacon of hope, reflected the faint light of the glyphs and the fiery glow of Ashtur's eyes. The warrior's muscles tensed, his senses heightened as he prepared for the desperate struggle ahead. The battle between Enki and Ashtur was a fierce and brutal clash, each strike and parry sending shockwaves through the temple. The ground beneath them quaked with the force of their combat, and the air vibrated with the energy of their confrontation. Ashtur's power was immense, a whirlwind of darkness and fury. Each of his blows carried the weight of centuries of imprisonment and rage. With every passing moment, it seemed as though victory might slip away from the valiant trio. Enki's strength, formidable as it was, began to wane under the relentless onslaught. The demon's laughter, deep and resonant, echoed through the chamber, a chilling reminder of the stakes they faced. But even in the face of such overwhelming power, hope remained. In a moment of unity, born from their shared struggle and unbreakable bond, Lilith and Enki combined their remaining strength. Lilith, her magic still weaving protective barriers, channeled her energy into a powerful shield that enveloped both Enki and Asher. The barrier glowed with an intense, radiant light, pushing back against Ashtur's dark magic. Enki, renewed by the protective embrace of Lilith's magic, fought with a vigor born of desperation and hope. His sword strikes became faster and more precise, each one a testament to his unwavering resolve to protect his friends and save his city. The synergy between his physical prowess and Lilith's magical support created a formidable defense that Ashtur struggled to break. Asher, shielded by their combined efforts, focused entirely on his incantations. His voice rose in a crescendo, each word a hammer striking the anvil of destiny. The temple resonated with his chant, the ancient magic responding to his call. The glyphs on the walls glowed brighter, their light merging with the energy of the incantation, amplifying its power. As Asher's voice reached its zenith, the temple filled with a blinding light. The intensity of the light was overwhelming, forcing even the darkest shadows to retreat. The very foundations of the temple shook as the ancient seal activated, its power a torrent of divine energy. Ashtur's screams of rage and despair echoed through the chamber, a final defiant roar as his malevolent form was drawn back into the ancient artifact. The light began to fade slowly, leaving behind a profound silence. The once chaotic chamber now felt serene, a place of peace and sanctity restored. The glyphs, their duty fulfilled, dimmed to a soft glow, and the air grew still. The sense of triumph and relief was palpable, a silent acknowledgement of the victory achieved. Babylon was saved. The citizens, freed from the demon's grasp, emerged into the light of a new dawn. Their hearts, once heavy with fear, now overflowed with gratitude and hope. The city, though scarred by the ordeal, stood resilient, its spirit unbroken. Asher, Lilith, and Enki, now hailed as the demon hunters, stood together, a testament to bravery and unity against the darkest of evils. Their names would be remembered, their deeds immortalized in the annals of history. They had faced the darkness and emerged victorious, their bond stronger than ever, their courage an enduring beacon for all who would hear their tale. The tale of the demon hunters would be whispered through the ages. A story of hope, courage, and the unyielding power of unity. Asher, Lilith, and Enki had proven that even in the darkest times, light could prevail, and that together they could overcome any challenge. And so, Babylon, bathed in the light of a new dawn, began its journey towards healing and renewal, guided by the enduring legacy of its heroes. And so, dear listeners, that was the tale of the demon hunters. Asher, Lilith, and Enki bravely confronted the dark forces of Ashtur and saved Babylon from imminent destruction. Their courage, unity, and determination shone brightly in the darkest of times. Remember, behind every challenge lies the opportunity for heroism, and in every shadow, a story awaits to be uncovered. If you enjoyed tonight's journey into the heart of ancient Babylon, please like, subscribe, and ring the notification bell so you never miss a mystical tale. What would you have done in their place? Would you stand against the darkness or seek another path? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Until next time, may your dreams be sweet and your nights filled with magical adventures.